Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, and Prince William have been married for more than 8 years, after meeting at the University of St Andrews in Scotland. They now have 3 children, and their life seems picture-perfect, however, it was not always the case. In 2007, the young couple briefly separated, which came as a shock to many. Reports of Kate and William splitting circulated in 2007, and BBC royal correspondent Peter Hunt said at the time, "It's a surprise because it had seemed very stable and very steady." In the royal documentary, William and Kate, The Journey, royal editor Duncan Larcom suggested a reason why the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge split. Mr. Larcom indicates the Middletons played a role in the breakup, explaining that William's friends used to mock Kate's family background. Mr. Larcom said, "One of the theories of mine is it was because of her family background." Although the palace denies this, Mr. Larcom revealed, one or two people in William's inner circle may have had that view. According to Mr. Larcom, William's friends used to laugh at Kate's mother, Carol Middleton, whose former job was as an air hostess. Mr. Larcom said, they used to say "doors to Manuel" whenever they saw Kate Middleton. However, royal author Christopher Anderson says it was Camilla, Duchess of Cornwall, and William's father Prince Charles who drove a wedge between the young couple. In his royal biography, Game of Crowns, Mr. Anderson focuses on 3 of the most famous Windsor women, the Queen, Camilla, and Kate. The author told, "I was in London when the breakup of Kate and William occurred. I was shocked, completely stunned. Everyone thought it was only a matter of time before William was going to ask Kate to marry him. And then people started telling me that Camilla was behind it." Mr. Anderson explained, "Camilla is a bit of a snob. She's an aristocrat, she has always been moving in royal circles. She had always thought of herself as the heiress to Alice Keppel, her great-grandmother, who was the mistress of Edward VII. She was very proud of the connection, she boasted about it as a child and as an adult, and that's what she intended to be, part of the royal circle in the role of mistress to the future king, and then the king. She did not look at Kate as someone who was worthy of joining the royal family. Kate is the first working-class woman to be accepted into the royal family. She is descended from coal miners and her mother was a flight attendant. So for all those reasons, Camilla never really felt that Kate Middleton as an individual and the Middleton family as a whole were going to be worthy of entering into the royal family. I was told at the time of the breakup, and later on as well, that Camilla basically whispered in Charles's ear that it was really time to force William to make a decision one way or the other. It has been since confirmed publicly that Charles did suggest to William that he either make a commitment to Kate or basically set her free, as it were. Now, his motives for doing that may have been pure, but Camilla not so much. She was the instigator of this. However, the pair soon reconciled and Prince William proposed in 2010 while the pair were holidaying in Kenya. They married a year later, at Westminster Abbey, and now are parents to Prince George, 6, Princess Charlotte, 4, and Prince Louis, 1. Kate, the Duchess of Cambridge, has been branded boring in a brutal attack by a US commentator after she broke royal protocol by wearing shorts for the first time in 10 years. Kate wore a pair of shorts for the first time in 11 years as she took part in the King's Cup regatta earlier this month. The last time the Duchess wore a pair of shorts in public was in September 2008, at the Dayglow Midnight Roller Disco Party in London, where she wore a yellow pair of mini shorts and a sequin green top. Commenting on the break from tradition on Page 6's Royal Roundtable, commentator Elaine Fishman said, "Kate Middleton was just spotted wearing shorts. I'm sure you must be asking yourself, what's the big deal? It's summer. Folks wear shorts." But to put this groundbreaking development in perspective, the last time Kate was spotted in shorts was 2008. Years before, she was a member of the royal family and was at a roller disco party, so it almost doesn't even count. Social editor Kristen McNamara said, "I just wish she had 1/10 of Princess Diana's sense of style." and that she maybe wore some tight biker shorts that Princess D used to wear with the oversized sweatshirt that looked so cute. They're back in style, but she's boring Kate, so what do we expect? I just have higher hopes and I was disappointed. Some social media users praised Kate's choice however, with one tweeting, "Good for her. It must be so refreshing for her to be comfortable." Another said, "Being royal does not mean that you can't do the thing that make you happy and she looks great." A third added, "Good for her." The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge are thought to be big sports fans, with Kate being the patron of the All England Lawn Tennis and Croquet Club. Kate has also been seen playing cricket in Mumbai and playing football with Prince William and local children at Windsor Park in Belfast. Columnist Ashley Pearson previously explained Kate's refusal to wear shorts. "Kate Middleton has a whole other set of rules and restrictions because she's going to be queen. Kate Middleton has to wear her skirts a certain length." Kate, the Duchess of Cambridge, faced off against Prince William during the King's Cup regatta on the Isle of Wight, but her team came out last. During the award ceremony, the Duke of Cambridge presented his wife a massive wooden spoon to mark her loss, an award the Duchess graciously accepted as she signaled her disappointment, covering her head with her hands. While the couple spent most of the time focused on promoting the charities they support during the event, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge caught the chance to spend time with their eldest children, Prince George and Princess Charlotte, who accompanied them to the Isle of Wight. The third in line to the throne received high praise for his adventurousness after survivalist Bear Grylls revealed George had eaten his first ant during the visit. Mr. Grylls, who beat both Kate and William in the race, joked with the crowd and the royals, suggesting the little prince may be interested in becoming his successor. As he held on to his trophy, the survivalist said, "And also Prince George, your first ant you ate today. And that is a great moment. Well done, you." His revelation left the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, who were listening to Mr. Grylls's acceptance speech from the side of the stage, in stitches. The King's Cup was a sailing regatta organized by Kensington Palace to raise awareness and funds for 8 organizations supported by the Cambridges. 6 celebrities attended and Kate and William raced as a skipper representing one charity each. William represented Child Bereavement UK and Kate the Royal Foundation's Early Years Programme. In a statement from Kensington Palace, Kate and William expressed the wish to see the King's Cup Regatta turn into an annual event for them to help promote their charities. The statement read, "Their Royal Highnesses hope that the King's Cup will become an annual event, bringing greater awareness to the wider benefits of sport, whilst also raising support and funds for the causes that the Duke and Duchess support."